Hello, my name's Nick, and I work at Waters Corporation as a Principal Analytical Scientist. In this short video, we're going to talk about multiple charging. We learned about the process of ion formation in the electrospray ionization, or ESI, in the electrospray video. In this video, we're going to look at how ions can be formed with more than one charge. We're going to look at multiply charged ions. In positive ion mode, cations, for example, hydrogen ions, will form bonds with lone pairs of electrons that are located on atoms in the analyte molecule of interest. These atoms are typically nitrogen, oxygen, or sulfur. In the adduct ion video, we looked at the example of Uvitex OB, an optical brightener polymer additive. Uvitex OB has a nominal mass of 430 and contains two nitrogen atoms, two oxygen atoms, and one sulfur atom. All five atoms could be the place where a cation could bond with a molecule, but in practice, other factors, such as relative basicity of each atom and or any steric hindrances, also come into play. In reality, only one cation, usually a proton in the case of Uvitex OB, bonds with a small molecule to make a single charged ion, probably on one of the nitrogen atoms. The story gets more complicated when we start to analyse large molecules using ESI. Large molecules, for example proteins or synthetic polymers, can have many, many places where cations could bond and add to charge the analyte. The larger the molecule, the more possible sites of cationization, and the more charges can be added to its structure, so the more charge an ion can carry. Let's consider what effect multiple charging will have on the mass spectrum. We know that the x-axis on a mass spectrum represents the mass of the ion divided by the charge the ion is carrying. This is very simple for single-charged ions, because that means the mass is divided by one. Each mass spectral peak represents the mass of the ion. If the charge on the ion is greater than 1, the m over z value of the peak no longer represents the mass of the ion. The peak is shifted to a lower value depending on the number of charges present. In the case of a molecule that has a mass of 1,000, if it becomes an adduct ion gaining one proton, then its mass will be 1,001, and the charge will be 1. So the ion will be observed at m over z 1,001. If the same molecule becomes an adduct ion gaining two protons, its overall mass will be 1,002, but the charge will also be 2, so the ion will be observed at 501, and so on. With three protons added, the mass is 1,003, and the charge 3, so the ion observed at 334.3, and with four protons added, the mass is 1,004, the charge is 4, and the ion is at m over z 251. If the same compound is observed to have different numbers of charges within the same spectrum, it's described as having different charge states. This phenomenon of multiple charges can be very useful because it enables us to analyse very high mass molecules, bringing them within the mass range of the mass spectrometer. The presence of carbon-13 isotopes and other atoms with isotopes in a molecule means that each analyte compound does not produce a single individual ion, but a cluster of ions depending on the distribution of isotopes present. You can learn more about this in the video about isotopes. Information about the number of charges on an ion can also be derived by examining the isotope clusters for that ion. However, we have to be careful because reasonably high mass resolution is usually required to be able to accurately distinguish the lower intensity isotopes. And often, quadrupole mass spectrometers do not deliver sufficient mass resolution for the user to see the isotope pattern clearly. The gap between the individual ions within an isotope cluster tells us the charge state of an ion. We'll look at some isotope model clusters to see how. Here, the single charge isotope cluster has a gap of 1 unit between adjacent ions. The isotope cluster for the same molecule with a double charge has a gap of 0.5 unit between the adjacent ions. And for an isotope cluster with triple charge, the gap is 0.33. Mathematically, the gap between the adjacent ions in an isotope cluster is given by 1 divided by the charge of the ion. So using this logic, we can deduce that a quadruply charged ion would have a gap of 0.25 units between the adjacent ions of a cluster. In this example, the data was acquired at a high-resolution mass spectrometer. Here we can see an extremely complex spectrum of a polymer sample called polyethylene glycol, or PEG. The structure of PEG has lots of sites where protons and other cations can join the molecule because there are many oxygen atoms regularly spaced along the polymer chain. PEG readily forms ions with multiple charges. If we take a closer look at some of the ion clusters within the spectrum, we can start to learn more about the different charge states present. Here, the ions are one unit apart, so they must have a single charge, whereas here, the gap is half a unit, so they must have a double charge. In fact, in this particular spectrum, we can distinguish charge states from 1+, all the way up to 7+. The gap between the ions in this cluster is approximately 0.14, which is 1 divided by 7. In the case of mass spectrometry of large biomolecules, it is possible for even higher numbers of charge states. For example, proteins with masses around 150,000 Daltons can have charges in excess of 20.